The second post-launch patch for Assassin's Creed Origins has dropped, and it's pretty significant, adding the long-awaited HDR option for everyone playing on those HDR TVs and way more. So let's unpack the most interesting features in this video. If you like that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go. With patch 1.03, the first patch after the big day 1 patch, Ubisoft applied a ton of fixes to the game, but there are also some noticeable changes and additions as well. One of the things is that you can now see an equipped icon in the upgrade menu of the blacksmith, so you know which weapon you are wearing and can easily upgrade it. There's an improved loot icon for the Hekka chest as well that you can buy at the Nomad's Bazaar, so if you're into those loot boxes, enjoy. I did not notice a difference when completing the regular daily quest that you can of course do every day. In terms of gameplay changes, there should be some improvements to the navigation of your playable character, NPCs and animals, and the overpowered chain throw damage should also be balanced. I tried this a lot though in the new patch, but it still seems pretty strong, giving you 2 easy kills at the start of a fight if you have the Adrenaline 2 ability unlocked. So yeah, it still seems pretty powerful. Sandstorms should now not happen anymore over water. Okay, that's weird that it first happened, of course. And there is a parry feature added to another playable character in the game, but I will not spoil who that is. Of course, it was already known that in Assassin's Creed Origins there would be multiple playable characters. If you still got some main missions to do, then you would be happy to hear that there will be various cinematic transitions improved with patch 1.03, and also improved the level of detail during several cinematic sequences. I already finished the game, but like I said, if you still got some main missions to do, then this is of course nice to hear that the cutscenes are improved. Just for if you have an HDR TV, because with this update you can witness better colors because of the HDR support that has finally been added. Apart from the HDR mode, I think that the photo mode upgrade is the most significant addition in this patch, because they removed the filters that, why would you use that, they were like really not beautiful at all, but giving you just more options in general. Like a full-on edit mode that now has a depth of field slider, but also where you can change the exposure, temperature, noise, and just a ton of new stuff. So you can make way cooler photo mode pictures. Look at this awesome shot, for example. I just toyed around with some of the sliders and got this, so yeah. You don't have to be a pro to get awesome shots. Also worth noting is that the photo mode can now not be used in the stone circles, and critical messages are also disabled while using the photo mode. Then last but not least, a small addition to the store in Assassin's Creed Origins, where you can buy things from Helix credits. You will see that the gear section now has categories, so now it's easier to find what you're looking for. And of course, with the new packs that are coming out, with the new weapons and stuff that Ubisoft will be added later on, it's just easier to find. Just hover over with your cursor and select what you want. Like I said, they also fixed a ton of issues, like where we could not pick up arrows in certain circumstances, or where we could not pick up loot bags if they dropped into cages. I put a link to the full patch notes of patch 1.03 in the description down below. If you found anything interesting with the patch, like hidden changes or whatsoever, please let me know, like things that they did not talk about but they still changed or tweaked in this patch. If it's anything substantial, I would love to cover that in another video. Subscribe to stay up to date on everything Assassin's Creed Origins, and check out my video on the channel where I discussed all the things coming to the game in November, and where I showed you the awesome bow that is one of the best in the game. Like the video to support the channel, thanks for watching, and goodbye.